Fellow Gambians, my first preoccupation as president and commander-in-chief of the armed forces and a patriot, and the most sacred at that, is to preserve at every instant and in every circumstance the lives of Gambians, and this is a duty I hold sacrosanct. I have always strived for peace and security of our nation and Africa. During this entire time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his infinite wisdom has permitted me to exercise power, and throughout the time that the sovereign people of the Gambia have put their confidence in me, my primary preoccupation has been to uphold the dignity of our people and the sovereignty of this great nation. As a result of all the numerous sacrifices that we and those before us have made as a nation, the Gambia has affirmed its desire to determine its own future and destiny. This is a cause I have always been ready to defend, and even with my life. All the actions we have taken towards building this nation up to this point have distinguished us among the community of nations and given us a pride of place in history. All this while, as a Muslim and a patriot, I believe it is not necessary that a single drop of blood be shed. Since the beginning of this political impasse that our dear nation is going through, I promise before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the entire nation that all the issues we currently face will be resolved peacefully. I am indeed thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that up till now, not even a single casualty has been registered. I believe in the importance of dialogue and in the capacity of Africans to resolve among themselves all the challenges on the way towards democracy, economic and social development. It is as a result of this that I have decided today, in good conscience, to relinquish the mantle of leadership of this great nation with infinite gratitude to all Gambians, women, children, youth, and men, and friends of the Gambia who have supported me for 22 years in the building of a modern Gambia. I put above all and everything the independence of the free and proud people of the Gambia, and I will always, together with you, defend this independence that we so dearly fought for and won. My decision today was not dictated by anything else but by the supreme interest of you, the Gambian people, and our dear country. Taking into consideration my prayer and desire that peace and security continue to reign in the Gambia. At a time when we are witnessing trouble and chaos in other parts of Africa and the world, the peace and security of the Gambia is our collective heritage, which we must jealously guard and defend. I am proud and honored to have served our country, the Gambia, while thanking all of you, men, women, and children, members of the armed and security services, humble citizens, and all those who have supported me or were against me during this period. I implore them all to put the supreme interest of our nation, the Gambia, above all partisan interests, and endeavor working together as one nation to continue to preserve the highly cherished achievements of the country, its sovereignty, peace, stability, and integrity as well as the economic achievements realized during these years. I pray that the Gambia, our homeland, continues to be united and prosperous for the welfare of each and every one of us and be the pride of all. I submit myself only to the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whose judgment is above and beyond man, time and history. The Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only guarantor of truth and justice. Finally, I am truly and sincerely proud to have been of service to you and our noble nation. I wish to thank each and every one of the security forces, members of government, present and past, my party militants, and most importantly, you, the Gambian people, and the National Assembly members, past and present, for the confidence vested in me and your loyal support. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to light and guide our path and to show his mercy and blessings on our great and beautiful country. I wish to take this opportunity to thank my mother, my wife and children for all their prayers and support throughout the past 22 years. I thank you all, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bless our motherland.